do this. Again, I do not find this game very horrific, like most people do. Sorry. It's, again, more about the expectancy of something happening than something actually happening. It's a dreary day out today. Did save up here. Excellent. So, we were last down. And there's this path here that I have yet to go on. So I'm actually gonna go back here. We're just done. Taking this path here. Jumped at me when I picked up a note. So my goal is to avoid them and get on that proper path here. Oops. Falling footprints. That's always a bad sign.
Today clearly got worse, just as our moods. We're all a little scared of what happened last night. There were even some suggestions of going back, but that was outvoted. We set off at around 10 a.m., going the same Mansi trail as we did earlier. We encountered a small camp of a local hunter during our hike. We asked if he had hunted the other night, but he said no. He told us a story about a ghost prowling through the forest in the form of a bright fog. Obviously, this did not make us feel better. We kept on going forward. Today, the hike was slow and difficult. The visibility is close to zero. The temperature dropped to minus 24 centigrade. Around 4 p.m., we had to start looking for a place to set up a camp. We found a good spot on the verge of the forest, covered from the wind. As exhausted as we were, we began setting it up. We were too tired to dig up a hole for the campfire. We ate dinner in our tents. We had no strength for any discussions or thoughts. At night, I clearly heard someone walking around the tent. I heard them whispering my name. I do not want to talk about it with the rest of the group. They'll think I'm going crazy.
Is that note? Right there. Okay, so I am now on this path. So big circle here. I don't know what that is, but we're gonna be checking it out. Rock that you're circling around. relies heavily on sound. Like, it makes you... hypersensitive. Circle around this. Before heading off. Well, I want to make sure I just get everything. I think I hear a waterfall. Okay, so I went wrong way. So, this, well, this path stick to this wall. I'm looking for more blind footprints. And sticking to the wall, because... well. Okay, it's hard for me to tell where I am. I mean, I imagine I'm somewhere in this area. I didn't see anything while hugging the wall. Let's see. F became one. Okay, so yes, this is, I think, is this also a path, or? Well, let me just keep my ears out for any piece of paper. Light pattern to it? Wrong thing. The human psyche. Dr. Wojcicki on delusional disorders. I've encountered an interesting case last year during my stay in the Moscow hospital. There is a patient in there who assaulted a woman. He kept on persisting that his friend told him to do so. He also claimed he was an officer of the government agency involved in studying unexplained phenomena. As absurd as it sounds, this man created such a strong illusion of those events in his head, of a life he never had, giving lots of details. We analyzed it. We tried to confirm them, of course. There was no reflection of reality in any of it. Here, I wish to explain the patient suffers from delusional disorder, among other delusions of influence, possession, or persecutory. I can't even read English. I have lately received information that he started claiming his body was falling apart, which means he has developed the Cotard delusion. The delusions are based on abnormal thinking and surrounding oneself with fictional reality, bogus events, non-existent people. The patient does not acknowledge presented evidence and that what they think is true is false. They even try coming up with their own evidence, confirming their version of events. This was the case with this patient as well. He described documents, which he claims he saw with his own eyes. Obviously, there was no confirmation in what he had said. We determined that our patient's problem is within an event in 1959 when a tragedy occurred in the Urals, where 9 ski hikers, mostly students, died. Unfortunately, we were still not able to explain how the patient could be connected to those events. It is possible that the information itself could have caused a serious trauma. Escape that way. That makes the most accurate sense, I think. There must be another path there. Just stick to this wall. I'm sure we'll find a path there eventually. We stuck to the wall. Do I see a fake one? Mm-hmm. it looks like the path is diverging three different directions.
Yeah.
So I think we're right here. And it looks like there's two paths here. And a circular path. So I could do this, circle around, maybe and hit that one or this one. I think that's semi straight ahead. Facing north. That's good. Yes. Right. This way. Looks like I'm at the end of it. So, I guess I'm actually right here. Okay, so... So actually I should go this way. Right? Should have been running. I didn't know that was there. You should have told me. I mean, now I know, but gosh darn. This is gonna take a little bit. My bad. Considering how long it's been since I got a note, I wonder if there was one near there. Because that would have been a great saving point. Thank you. probably skip them for this. I don't want to fall. No matter what, I'm gonna have to run in that. Yep. Okay. I'm running with all y'all. Whoa. So, if there is a piece of paper, it's not mapping. I'm gonna just check whether I'm on the river and then it doubles around up top. There are no paragraphs to this. Dimitra Ivan Ostis. 54. First we heard a snap, you know, like a tree being brought down. I told Blank to go check it out because it seemed like the sun was coming out of the chamber. Blank stood up and went to check the readings. He said everything was fine, and then the door started to bend, you know? Bulge. As if you'd been pumping a balloon. Finally, the doors just burst into the room. Straight off the front frame, poor Blank was standing in front of me, and those doors just wiped him out. I saw everything in slow motion. I thought someone was soon going to enter the room. The military, or maybe we were being attacked by the Americans. But nobody came. Only Blank buried his head in his hands and started screaming like a wounded animal. I will never forget the sound of that scream. Then he stood up, turned his back to us, and his head spun around. He stood like that, looking at us. I don't know how much time had passed, maybe a second, but for me, it was an hour. I shouted to run, save yourself. Then Blank finally fell to the ground, and Blank jumped to his feet as if he wanted to say something, but his face, I don't know. Inspector, I think I've gone mad. Voice from the room. Please continue, Dr. Dempster. His face started falling apart. Part by part, like fragments of a broken porcelain mask. Then objects started levitating, desks moving, weird screaming and loud banging. Everyone started screaming. I screamed too. I felt like, you know, something was boiling inside of me. I had to escape. I started crawling. There's something spilt on the floor, but I kept crawling through it. I remember closing my eyes and moving in forward from memory. I could only hear roars and screams until finally something exploded. Everything went quiet. I don't know how much time had passed when I lied motionless on the floor. At last, I opened my eyes, but it was dark all around, you know? I crawled to the corridor. I slowly stood up and saw that at the end of the tunnel, the red emergency light was barely flashing. I began moving towards the end of the tunnel, every now and then stumbling on something. When I came close to the light, I froze. I closed my eyes again. Voice from room. Dimitra, you're doing great. Please continue. Yes, of course. I apologize, but I don't know. I mean, I closed my eyes because I couldn't believe it. At the end of the corridor, went sideways to the left and right in both directions. There were people standing, melted together with objects, with the walls, you know, like mixed up as if someone took a large spoon and stirred a part of the world. Okay. Right there's my save point, I think. Yeah, that's like right in the center. I'm surprised I didn't find anything else along this path here. That's quite the large gap. I may have to go back and check that out later. First, I want to try and get that piece that's up here. And then I'll continue down that spookly path. I don't know why, but the tree just doesn't look safe. Then we saw lights in the sky, a lot of lights. Orange spheres were hovering over the pool area, and it seemed like a strange orange fog was coming out of every crack. We saw a man who came out of that light. I remember I just started shouting, and he came up to me, my hand on. But we got a safe point right here. Close to this creepy ass tree. Which I think is a good thing. Alright, so let's go up to this creepy ass tree. So that's all. imagine I'm gonna have to find that.
I am an empty wreck. Made in his image, but not alike. A servant, obedient to one master. My body is a shell, and I am ready to absorb him. Now I see the plan. I see the magnitude of devastation. The Creator summons me, and I want to be his food. I am humming his tune. I am looking at the world through his eyes. I drink the blood of his enemies and taste the rotting bodies. I feel the sin sprouting under my skin. I hear screams in my head. I hear them calling me. I hear the calling of the ones that through him have already found their eternal shelter. Free them, my lord! Free them and take me instead! Fulfill your revenge! At the hour of my death, an army of angels comes out from the orange light. Their song is made of one powerful voice. I feel their presence, their twisted faces, their black eyes drilling into my consciousness. They demand to finish the work. Oh, his presence is overcoming me. So poor and defenseless. What have they done to you? What harm? There is a place. You were there, and so was I. A huge gate, and the Creator hidden behind it. Only those few who touched him could understand, but you could. You understood, and I understood through you.
I was out of stamina. Okay, so I'm going to circle around that rock like I did to avoid the one. I'm probably going to backtrack instead of trying to run for the burnt trees. Because that just makes the most sense. I think. Come on, run button, run! Okay, so I'll just stick to this one. Looks like there'll be a lot of them have. At some point. Which I can follow back down. So, the lake starts here. I think I'm back to this one, which means I passed up that one. And I really want to go to that burnt forest. Because I imagine that's one of the places I do need to go. And then go there. And stick to it. Should be yet there's burnt floors. Oh. Hello, Mr. Campfire. I didn't know you were here. Okay, so I'm right there. And this, I guarantee you, this is gonna be. I think I'm gonna have to really be on the lookout for footprints.
Dear Vera, I'm spending my time in the Institute on long walks in the park. Only here I can find solace, only in the shadows of the trees. My thoughts are peaceful when I see how the sun brushes the green leaves and the wind covers my face in a gentle, warm blow. The doctors say the worst is behind me. The breakdown was temporary. It's difficult for me to say what triggered this state. I know you'll never forgive me for what I've done. The tragedy that I've contributed to shall never find any justification nor explanation. I can only cover it up with madness. But I am aware that this is a pathetic excuse, and I'm not able to hide behind it. I take full responsibility for what happened. And I am prepared to be punished. The doctors, however, say I will probably not leave the Institute. You must know I would rather rot in prison 100 times for what I have done to you. I have to confess, I tricked you. I knew you would never, ever want to hear what I have to say to you. That is why I sent my friend with this letter to your sister, and after a lot of persuasion, she agreed to read it to you. I thank her from the bottom of my heart for this. I'm ending this letter. I want to bore you no more. I love you and believe that someday, hopefully, I will be able to tell you all this in person. Luckily, my friend Anton is by my side at all times. He was the one that went to your sister. I hope this letter finds you both well and in good health. I wish you all the best. Forever yours, Vitaly.
Okay. I am ready to run. Let's do this. Break. I'm actually hungry after all that. I have returned from my meal. Bologna and crackers. Okay. So I imagine there's another one up in this weird hodgepodge over here. I know there was a thing here somewhere. I could hear it from down here. So I'm going to follow the path back up to here. Take that around. And get that piece of paper, because I want to know what it is. Once more, we are going up this path. It isn't the first junction, but the second, right? Yes. Second. That'll be the second fork in the road. That's the thing about mountains. Sounds really do echo. Be taking the eastern path, taking right path. I've already taken and just didn't realize it before. And right there, I thought it was that black stuff that was just put out. A 27-year-old woman is dead. The murderer mutilated. Overnight from Friday to Saturday in a house in the center of Moscow, the body of 20-year-old Victoria R. was found. The victim had multiple injuries as well as serious harm inflicted to the eyes. The perpetrator has not been caught yet. No traces of forcible entry were noted. Doors to the apartment as well as all windows were closed from the inside. Victoria R. was the sister of 35-year-old Indira R., who was similarly injured by her partner, G. Detective ruled out his connections to crime committed due to him being locked up in a mental institution. Detectives do not rule out that he could have had a partner. He said his own name. I can have it. Oh, I'm still on this. Okay. So I'm right. I haven't seen the form. Just yet. I was worried there for a second. Did I miss the form? Rooms. I love you too, Mr. your putty tat. Why are you bugging me? Do I still smell like learning? Is that it? Oh. I wish I could read them. Okay, here's the portal. So that goes up, and this should lead me to where that one. No! For God's sake, putty tat. Learn to listen. You do not get in front of the screen while I'm playing a game. I know you want all my attention, but I can't give all. You're gonna be the death of me. That's an interesting sound. No. Okay, here's a piece of paper.
We set off quite late today. I think everyone heard something at night, but they are afraid to admit it. I walked around the tents, but didn't notice any tracks. We didn't talk too much. We barely hiked 2.5 miles. We got the impression that something clearly changed around us. I felt someone was observing us, and I think the others had a similar feeling because they mentioned the hunter was heading in the same direction. We won't make it any further. I think we'll stay here.
So now I'm gonna backtrack and see what's up with this wild area. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You said there were 11 areas, right? 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Maybe that one note wasn't talking about it. I don't know. Maybe I'm missing shit. I thought that meant there were 11 spots, but... I guess not. I think I passed one fork. I think this is the other fork. I can't be certain. Oops. No, this is the way I came from. So this is the first fork. This way. I just realized that looks like a mushroom. Obviously, either this or this is going to dead end to something. But, so, I'm going to go along this path here, hit this, see if there's anything there, then come back this way and hit that. Hit the mushroom. I'll hit the mushroom last. I don't want to be tripping while walking around here. Make sure if I did that, I
eons. That's how long I spent, suspended in nothingness. And then this one time, a pale, dim glow filled it. I felt as if some consciousness started soaking through an orange cloud into my brain, dripping with heavy drops, not letting me pass away nice and peaceful. I fought with myself. I had no strength to open my eyes. And finally, after processing this situation on and on, I realized I have no eyes.
Oh, I wouldn't be able to go that way even if I wanted to. Okay, dude, you have no eyes. You probably clawed them out. Sounds like it may be in there. If I'm... Okay, I assume these are drop down points. Yeah, return. So, if I think about this logically, that drop down points... piece of paper, what this is. If I'm to go the logical route, this route would be shorter. Because I could fast travel here, then do that, and I wouldn't be spending as much time in these caves, which are probably dangerous. I think I'm gonna do that. Travel to this one. Wow, that was fast. I started to lean back in my chair and then poof, we were there. piece of paper, decent distance in. That's a point of no return from here. So that's a point of no return. So I do have to go that way. Follow this around. Grab the piece of paper there. Come back. Check this place out. Okay, so there's gonna be a lot of running around then. And that is honestly rather disappointing. But at least now I know I'm probably supposed to run that way? Question mark? And if I have to run that way, I'll at least do it. Damn, that sounded close. I don't think wolves are actually a thing here. I think it's just ambiance. Make it a little bit more spooky. Oh. Okay. Don't look behind me, don't look behind me. I know there's something there. Most likely. So this is the drop down point. I imagine that's gonna be right here then. So it ain't gonna be too far to get to this, which will lead to that. Which button was the flash? There's the flash. It made the cave spooky.
probably goes that way that far. I think this is the way I want to go to get that piece of paper. I'm hoping. I really don't know. It's too bad you don't have a marker on the map for yourself. Probably did that because you know.
Think you are significant, that you will uncover the truth for everyone to see, so you can point the finger at the monster. First, take a look at the mirror.
Seemed to trigger something. I want to get the piece of paper first. I like that noise. Okay. So, I look like water. Okay, I dropped down here, so the campfire's like right here, I think. So, I'm missing something somewhere. Like, the path I am looking for should not be that far.
Kholat Shyokol. Will we ever find out what really happened? Another anniversary of the mysterious incident on the east shoulder of the mountain. Kholat and Shyokol and the northern Urals pass us by, and we're not even a millimeter closer to finding out the truth about the tragedy. Many different hypotheses created throughout the years caused the truth to disappear. A sudden avalanche, natives attack, military test, or maybe, as some suggest, contact with an extraterrestrial civilization. Aliens. What exactly happened and at the night of February 1 and 2nd in 1959, whatever it was, it is crucial we remember about the 9 young people whose lives were prematurely ended. So I was right not to touch that first light I saw. I mean, I didn't realize they were enemies, but, you know. I've played sniper games. There is a bright light shining from nowhere. That is dangerous. I mean, something's ready to key. Okay. So yes, I got the piece of paper that was right there. Awesome. Awesome sauce. Wasn't there before, was it? Or was I just blinded by the fact I'm single-minded? Where is it? Oh, wait a minute. I jumped right over it. Oh, my bad.
It's dark. We escaped to the forest. Something tried to get in the tent. We heard strange sounds and an orange light. We are not going to escape from this. We are going to die. I don't know what's going on. I wanted to try, but I can't.
Okay, so where are we? We are right here. Okay. There's no way I can jump that back, because that's slightly higher. So apparently. Okay. Apparently I am a fool. I thought we could go back the way we came, but that's just too much higher, and there's no actual jump button. You legitimately just run, and it will... You'll slide into place, kind of. So I need to actually drop down out here. And then circle back around. So we did not end up where I thought we ended up. Would end up. Again, I'm just gonna hug this. Go around you two. Oh, I did not see that one before. And we're just gonna walk on thin air. Because, you know, that's what people do. Okay, so now I got those two. The cave is extremely confusing. Not gonna lie. Okay, so we're gonna follow this path again.
sounds like people screaming. Okay, we're gonna keep an eye out for the one light that I saw here previously. There it is. Okay. So. Drop. 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 I can't see shit. Okay. I just wanted to make sure I wasn't dropping into a bottomless pit. Okay. So, in following that around, we did manage to make it to this. How? I'm not exactly certain. I guess we can try this uppermost path? Question mark? Well, I honestly don't know which one of these is which. All I know is that one eventually leads to where that note was. So, actually, that means we drop down here. Okay, so if that one leads to the note, this one will lead, the one I'm facing will lead to the lake. That one there will lead to the lake. And the one behind the fire leads to the mushroom. That's what I'm getting. That sounded like a knife flying by my head. Just saying. Spooked for good reason. And more of this symbol. Here's the lake. Menacing that could be another possible, or, you know, story based area. So you come out here. Oh, to complete the circle, I gotcha. That is actually supposed to continue from the caves to this guy, I think. That's what that's supposed to be for. Okay. Or, you know, you could go from that guy into the caves. It don't really matter. It's curious how there's this circle of green. Okay, watch out for the light. Oh, there's two of them, one on each side. I did not know that. Oh. Yeah, I'm just gonna... Okay. I'd rather do it with my light off, that way I can see those. It's harder to see them with the light on. There's lights down there, and I think, yes, I'm hearing a piece of paper. So somewhere down there is a piece of paper. I think I'm actually done for now. That's difficult. I do want to step in one of the lights just to see what would happen, though. So I'm going to do that, then, you know. Back here. Like I said, I just want to step into one lights and see what happens. Actually, I think I'll go to the campfire so I can save there and then step into one of the lights. That way I don't have to worry about coming back through this area again. So like I said, I'm just curious as to what will happen if I do step in them. Do I get beamed up like Scotty? True, in fact, he never actually says beam me up Scotty, he says Scotty, beam me up. Fast jump to save. I don't have to fast jump to save at all. But I'm doing it just in case. Step in the light just real quick to see what else.
what's a... So there is a light that's not too far in, thankfully. It's just beyond this point. You're howling. Oh! The mountains are howling and crying in pain. Alright, there's one that appears right there. Let's see this. Wait. Huh? Do I actually not have to worry about him? Here I was avoiding them, like the plague, because I thought they were something. And they just may not be nothing? Or could they be... So I was avoiding them for nothing. That is great. I honestly thought they were like freaking sniper things. So maybe this next part isn't as difficult as I thought.
You think you are significant? That you will uncover the truth for everyone to see? So you can point the finger at the monster? First, take a look at the mirror.
Yeah, I know, I'm a monster. You don't have to tell me. So I don't actually have to worry about them. I do have to worry about him.
I am right behind you.
Yes, I am. There was a footprint in front of me, so I failed. Okay. Well, now that I know, I don't have to worry. Okay, I am not ending this here. Not until I finish this last part. I am almost there. Almost. There is that paper I want to grab, but I don't think I can grab it. I think I'm going to have to run from him and come back and get it. Let's do this. I do want to see this here. Oh! Never mind! That could have been deadly for me. That could have been seriously bad. Whew. Quick reflexes, yo. I know how to back the hell up. Beep, 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 beep. Ooh, that was bad. That was a bad joke. I do have a wide load. Here.
This one. I'm also pretty glad these moving, glowing things aren't actual enemies. They may just be spirits. Like, kinda
you. You think you're significant?
Yeah.
That you will uncover the truth for everyone to see?
Oh, definitely.
So you can point the finger at the monster. First,
absolutely.
Take a look at the mirror.
Yes, you are ugly. Follow her. Oh, shit. I'm out of stamina. I'm gonna try this upper path and hope it works better. I just need to. Okay, so I managed to dodge two of them. I think I'm in the mushroom. I think I'm up in this portion here. And I know I heard the piece of paper. And I guarantee it's probably right. I hear crying. Keep an eye out for his footsteps. I'm hearing the piece of paper. Not seeing any footsteps. Okay, so if you wait a moment. You must come here. Your agent has gone missing. The past is off limits. We don't know what's going on. 9 people are dead. Before dying, the agent asked, "Where is Anton?" Okay. Is he stuck there? To go along this northern part because I saw the enemy down here. He's coming this way.
Thank you.
go. Where is it? There it is. No? Oh.
Whoever you are, if you are reading these words, I beg of you, help us. We are in a place they call Post Office Box 5. I don't know where this is. I don't even know what year it is. They are not allowing anyone from the outside to have contact with us. They lock us up in cells, 4 in each. I saw dozens of cells like that. They talk about something they called Anomaly 7. Every day we undergo tests, research, tortures. I have seen how they kill people. I have seen terrible things. Write about it. Let the world know. They conduct the worst experiments possible. They have something that we call the fear chamber. There is no way to say what will happen to the person that ends up there. Some come back, but are no longer themselves. They are absent. Others are dragged out dead. Only few stay sane. I have seen a bright orange light, which spoke to me in demonic voices, and showed me things worse than any nightmare you can possibly dream. Sometimes people come out of there with broken bones, mutilated, crushed, irradiated, dismembered. I can't take it in anymore. Take away these images. There is a scientist amongst us. He said that during their sick experiments, they discovered something. Out of this world. They are trying to test it. The truth is that it is testing them. He told us that there are more places like this around the world, and there will come a day the gates of hell will open. You have to stop this. Destroy it. Destroy us. Kill us all. The center is governed by something that is called the Soviet Research Unit for Natural Phenomena. I have seen this on an ID card of the man that was interrogating me. He said we were prisoners, convicts, murderers, rapists, thieves. But that is not true. I have done nothing wrong. I hate them all. They call us subjects. No names, but subjects. I am Subject 73. I don't even remember my real name. I beg of you, please help us. Burn it all to the ground. If only this letter reached beyond the walls of the center. If only the guard who promised to take it has kept her promise. You have to do something. I swear by all that one holds sacred, you have to. My only cellmate, Anton, whispers in my ear that everything is going to be fine. That the orange light is singing in the voices of hundreds of angel choirs. Anton promised me that if I listen carefully to the singing, he will free me. Sometimes, however, I think that all of this does not exist. There is no prison. There are no bars. There are no doctors. There is no Anton. There's only this frightening, piercing orange light.
Okay. So there's got to be a way out. I was already up that way. What is that? I'm gonna have to Google that word. Doesn't sound good, whatever that is. Yeah, let me look up what a yes. Back to the center. I thought there was, or not. Oh, so that's what that noise was. Whoa. Near that. Let me just have a look here. Okay, so we have three letters there. Three letters there. Five in that area. One here. There. Four there. Did I? Okay. So, there is something I'm missing. I didn't go down this path, it looks like. Okay. So, I'm gonna go faster. I'm gonna fast travel to the one letter I'm missing here. Because I just looked it up. I am missing one letter, and I'm gonna go get it.
Thank you.
three notes up here. Here, two, there. There.
And so, we have reached the end. Have you understood your role in my plan? There are no random victims, and nobody is completely innocent. You may not agree, but when the gates to Section 22 open and the world will see true madness, you will understand that everything I had done was necessary.
See you now. Doc? Doc, can you hear me? It's Anton. That's enough for today. The patient's results are deteriorating. Let's disconnect him. Shit! Turn it off! Quickly! Do it! He can hear us!
End of the game. Nope, enjoy the credits.
You are safe.